Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome to Candy's Cozy Couch. My name is Candace, and my nickname is Candy. That's how I came up with that really accomplished name. Yes, accomplished. Good way to describe the day, actually. I feel like I had a pretty accomplished day. And I want to get right into our story for the evening, but hopefully you guys are moving through the rudiments of your bedtime routine. And you're getting all the important things done that need to be done before you settle in for bed for a good night's sleep. Your checklist may vary, but most of us are doing pretty much the same type of things to prepare ourselves for a good night. So get to it, because I know you can do it. Now, we've got this interesting weather for it being January. And so I checked out from the library a book about rain. Cute little story. It's called Rain, and it is written by Marion Dane Bauer and illustrated by John Wallace. So just a cute little book here. It says, drip, drop, plop. Rain falls from the sky. Rain turns dirt into mud and makes puddles on sidewalks. It also helps flowers grow. But where does rain come from? The answer is at your fingertips. Just open this book and read about the wonders of rain. Oh, look, and they say don't miss these other books on weather, snow, wind, and clouds. That's good to know. I'm going to look for them. Might as well do them all. But yeah, it is raining. Now, mind you, it's been a nice day. We started out with sunshine. I actually started the day out with a bike ride. And it was Martin Luther King Day today. So, did a march and a rally and all kinds of stuff. And all of a sudden, end of the day, it's raining. All right. Rain. So, we're going to talk about it. The precipitation that's not white and fluffy, more like wet and soggy. The day is hot. Well, it wasn't quite hot today, but it wasn't really cold either. The sun shines bright, the flowers wilt, the grass goes limp. Now, wait a minute. Why did that happen? What's going on here? Even the birds are still. And then a gray cloud covers the sun. And the sun is like, move, cloud. Get out the way. You're blocking my light. And that cloud like, hold up. Wait a minute. That's my turn now. The cloud is made of tiny drops of water. The drops grow larger and larger. And I think you guys know what happens when that occurs. The cloud gets too full of water and don't have no room. They bump into one another. Mm-hmm. They grow so heavy that they fall out of the cloud. And that is what is happening right now. The clouds outside are releasing water. Rain! Yep, rain. The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plain. Again. No, I'm kidding. The flowers drink, the grass drinks, because that is good for the earth. Everything needs water. The birds drink, of course. The world is fresh and clean. Except this time of year, the rain should actually be snow. But I'm rolling with it. The sun comes out again, bright and hot. It shines and shines and shines. Until what? Where did the puddle go? Into the air. Whoa. So that's evaporation. Into the sky. Into the cloud up there. That's the water cycle. Evaporation, precipitation, evaporation, condensation, water cycle. And then the tiny drops of water gather into clouds again. The drops grow heavier and heavier until what? Dun, 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 dun. Rain falls once more. And that's how that water cycle works. The water cycle. And the whole world smiles. So if you enjoy rain, this is a book for you. Wait, now here's something interesting. On the back page, it says, facts about rain. It takes millions of cloud droplets to form one raindrop. What? The first drops of rain that fall are apt to be larger than latter ones because the heaviest drops fall first. Okay. Raindrops are different shapes and sizes. Small ones are round like balls. Bigger ones flattened on the bottom as they fall so their sides bulge out. Okay. Even in summer, many raindrops start out as ice. What? Crystals, because the air very high in the sky is cold. Okay. If the weather on the ground is warm, the ice turns into water as it falls. Scientists can make a cloud rain by dropping chemicals such as dry ice into them. The ice crystals encourage other crystals to begin to join together. When enough gather together, they fall as rain. Wow. And here's the final tidbit. The water we have on Earth is all we will ever have. We must use the same water again and again and again. First is water, then is rain or snow, then is water again. That is why it is so important that we keep our lakes and rivers and oceans clean. And there it is. I just read that. Well, all right. That's something to keep in mind. All right, boys and girls. Well, there you have it. A little story about rain. Because it is actually raining in January. I'm looking forward to some snow so I can go sledding and stuff. It's either going to come or it's not. I'm here for it either way. All right, boys and girls, it's that time to get yourself settled in bed. Tomorrow we go back to school, getting back on track after the holiday. So, tuck yourselves in, snug as a bug in a rug. Tucked in tight, ready for a good night, safe and sound, right where you need to be found. All right. Comfy and cozy. Don't be trying to be nosy. Just get ready to dream your dream. Get your cuddle buddy. Close your eyes. Whisper to yourself what you would like to dream about. Perhaps rain or snow or neither. It's up to you. Whatever you like to dream about, you go for it. Now close your eyes and allow yourself, your body, to drift off to sleep so that you can dream your special dream. All right, boys and girls, thanks for hanging out with me on Candy's Cozy Couch. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.